Let's say I have a spring laying on a frictionless horizontal surface. So I attach one end of the spring to a wall, spring in natural shape. There is no horizontal force acting on the spring. Spring neither stretch nor compress. So let's say I applied a force of 2 newtons to the right. So basically I stretch the spring. Okay. So length of the spring will be increased and this point go to the right. So basically displacement of this point, if we call x1, 0.05 meters or 5 centimeters. So this is the force Fa, 2 newtons, force applied to the spring. So when I apply this force, there will be reaction force, same in magnitude but opposite in direction. This is Fs, 2 newtons. This force is called force applied by the spring or restoring force. This is force applied to the spring. Okay, let's say I increase this force to 4 newtons. In this case, stretch become more. So, okay, let's say point comes somewhere here. So I apply Fa2 for newtons. Let's say this is one. So reaction force Fs2 will be also 4 newtons. In this case, displacement from the original position will be, let's say, x2 10 centimeters or 0.10 meters. Okay, so I can continue my experiment, increase this 2 more, so 6 newtons, then 8 newtons, 10 newtons. I cannot do this forever. At some point spring gets deformed. Okay, but this case spring is not deformed. When I remove this force slowly, then spring exactly come to the original shape. It doesn't get deformed. Okay, let me put those value on a table. So this is x meter displacement, this is F applied newtons. So 0 newton, I didn't apply any force, so displacement 0. So 2 newtons 0.05 meters, 4 newtons 0.10. Let's say I did for 6 newtons same way, so I get 0.15. Okay, so we prepared table of values from our experiment. So let me plot those values on a graph. So horizontal axis x per meter and applied force on newton. So this first one 0.00 and this second point, third one this one. So when we draw the line, it comes like this. Beyond this, let's assume we continue our experiment. So graph go linear. After some point, it is not linear anymore. So until here, it is linear. So this point is called elastic limit. It means, so if you go here, let's say this is 7.6 newtons. So if we apply more than 7.6 newtons, then spring gets deformed. Less than this force, this will be line. So it means this is elastic region. Elastic region. So when we remove the force on the spring, spring comes to the original shape if force less than this. But if we apply more than this amount, then spring gets deformed. Even we remove the force, spring shape get deforms. So if we continue experiment, we may get a point here. This is breaking point. At this point, let's say we apply something 9 newtons, then spring is fracturated. Okay, so we are interested is this linear region. We call this Hooke's law region. So how can we find the slope of this line? Let's call slope is k. K equal, so delta f a over delta x, so rise over run. So it means we take 2 points on the graph. Let's say take this this point. Okay, we take this point and this point. So 6 minus 0 newtons, then we get 0.15 meters minus 0 meters. So when we divide this, we get 40 newtons per meter. Okay, I write here again, k equal 40 newtons per meter. What is k? K is called spring constant or force constant. So when we look at this line, so we can write this formula. Okay, we write this formula. F A equal K times X. So when we look this graph or this equation, we can see this F A is directly proportional to the X. This relation is called Hooke's law. Any spring obeys to Hooke's law is called ideal spring. In physics books, you can see two versions of the formula. One has positive, one is negative. So why this is this? So I am going to explain. Okay. Let's say there is a spring. So I apply a force to the right. So Fs will be the to the left. This is called force exerted by the spring, or another name, restoring force. What is restoring force means? So this force always try to bring the spring to unstretched position, direct to the unstretched position. So in this case, so displacement will be positive direction, x. So x will be positive, Fa will be positive direction, Fs will be negative direction. Okay, if this case I try to stretch the spring Fa, so restoring force or force exerted by the spring Fs, so in this case displacement will be negative direction. So Fa will be negative direction, Fs will be positive direction. Okay, K is spring constant, is always positive. So that is the reason. So Fs and displacement always opposite direction, but Fa and displacement always same direction. That is the reason this formula has negative sign. Okay, what is K? It is spring constant or force constant. Spring constant measures the stiffness of the spring. more stiff spring has larger K value. This is less stiff. Okay, let's estimate the K value. Let's say this is K equal 20 for this spring. Let's say K equal 60 newtons per meter. Okay, newtons per meter. I am gonna finish this video by giving a simple example. Okay, there is a spring scale. It is a relaxed position. There is no compression. So this is me, my mass 80 kilogram. I step on this spring scale and spring scale compress 1.2 centimeter. Question 1. Find the force exerted on me by the spring scale and force exerted by the spring scale on me. Okay, first of all, I have to find my weight. Fg equal m times g, mass 80 kilogram times 9.8 newton per kilogram, then my weight will be 784 newtons down. Basically, this is the force exerted by me on the spring scale. Okay, so Fs will be the opposite direction, same magnitude, 784 newtons up. This is the reaction force. So force exerted by spring scale on me. Okay, second question. Find the spring constant. So as you know, F equal K times X. So from here, K equal F over X. So F will be 784 newtons. X, I have to convert to meters. So 12 meters. From here, I calculated 65,333 newtons per meter. Okay. Thank you very much for watching my video. Have a nice day.